Hello everyone, playing Pokemon Coliseum here, back on part 3 of what I recorded. Might be only the second video you see here, uploaded pretty close together. Basically, this is the Shadow Entei fight that I was trying to get on camera last time and didn't, and failed unfortunately, but that probably would have been a funny video to upload and whatnot if I would have had the chance. So I'm trying my best here, and there's been a decent amount of battles on the way here, and I'm actually kind of surprised how difficult it is at the moment, because I'm fairly underleveled, as you can probably see. And I've ran out of a lot of my items and my hit points, or not hit points, but power points. So that's pretty much where I'm at the moment, and that's all there really is to say. They're going to probably keep doing the Earthquake Protect combo, which I would like to get them out before Entei comes in because of that reason. They'll just keep Earthquaking and basically knock out the Entei. So, I mean, it's not looking too great. See, like, one shot already took him down to 10 health. I thought about going for the mud shot there afterwards. I really don't need to though, because Entei is the last one, thankfully. Meditite is going to give me the chance to heal up, because I'm not playing around with this. I know that Entei is not going to be a joke. Okay, at least he didn't protect. I'm surprised he didn't, though. But I reckon he knew he could knock me out, so he took it. Still would have with the protect, though, too. So, to each their own. Okay, pretty much a one for one here, let's say. Cool. Doubled up on me. Ground moves don't work on my flying type. Now this should be an interesting situation here, because Marsh Tomp is going to be an interesting situation to get rid of. This could take a little bit of time here. Frankly, I don't really have a great plan for this. I think Entei could take a Surf. Well, okay. Now it's back to the whole, is Marsh Tomp going to use Earthquake? And if he does, it's going to basically, I mean, it's probably going to knock out Entei. Nice. I really need that Marsh Tomp to go. Oh, Entei's fine with that. Mostly it's just preservation here. Question is, how many hits can I take? Cool. Probably about time to heal up. Of course you avoid the attack. That's too perfect. I don't know if I can paralyze a ground type through Thunder Wave on Generation 3. That's why I just didn't try. The double heal is going to be the best play here. Maybe not the best play, but it's gonna get me enough. It's gonna be worth it in the long run. As long as I don't start missing all my attacks due to muddy water, which is a possibility. And Frost only has electric moves, so they're no good against Marsh Tom. I'd rather just heal up than to just keep on reviving and minusing myself. Usually I do minus myself and just kind of go in that direction, but it's not really the ideal behind it. Yeah, I've always thought Marsh Chomp was one of the more annoying parts of the team. And so is Golem and Metang if they start getting that protect combo and all that. Okay, Fire Blast. I bet you hit Ampharos again. This is getting very redundant at this point. Basically just hoping for luck. Cool. It's about time. I'm actually going to go for another heal here. None of them are really ideal. Sure. Okay, and this is where we were wanting to be. I really didn't even need to heal up the good old Swablu. It wasn't completely necessary. I considered throwing a ball there, but I didn't even realize I meant to heal instead. So now it's really up to him how many times he's going to use his shadow moves and start doing stuff, since he's basically ran out of his fire move. Now it's time to hope for the best. Ultra Ball. And heal. Sure, I have plenty of money at this point to replace a lot of these items. I actually may do some training here, probably at Mountain Battle, just to raise some levels. As you can see, it's pretty hard. I was trying to think of a clever trick to make him miss or something, but there's really nothing. I do believe he has Stomp. I'm not like extremely upset if I don't catch Entei here on this time, but it's still like, why am I not able to catch this twice in a row? Like, it's just annoying. There it goes. So missed out on Entei here. I reckon, there you go. There's some proof of how that works. Thanks for watching. Love you guys. Have a good day. Bye.